Hello, and welcome back to Elite Cloud. Today, we're going to learn how to create an access key for AWS CLI. First, navigate to IAM. From there, select Users and choose the user to whom you want to assign the access key. One important thing to note is that, depending on the user's specified policy, the IAM access key will receive permissions. If you have a user with limited access permission, that user will not gain any additional permissions. It's crucial to remember this detail. Now, click on Create Access Key and select Command Line, CLI, as we will be using this with AWS CLI. Click on Confirm I understand and want to proceed to create a new access key. Then click on Next. Here, you can give a description, like Test CLI. This step is optional, feel free to skip it if you prefer. Then, click on Create Access Key. This action will generate the access key for you. This is your access key, and this is your secret access key. Think of them as a username and password, and ensure you never share these with anyone. Once the access key is created, proceed to a terminal. Check if AWS CLI is installed. If not, refer to our previous videos or install it independently. Type AWS configure. If you previously had any access key, the last four characters will be displayed. Now, enter your new access key and the secret access key. For the region, I chose a East 1. And I'll keep the format as none. Your AWS CLI is now configured. To verify, issue a command to list all the available S3 buckets in your current AWS account. As you can see, we have only one bucket, Elite Cloud 3. If you check this S3 bucket in your console, you will see it matches the one displayed here. This confirms that we have successfully connected AWS CLI using this access key. Remember, this access key is highly sensitive. If it's not in use, consider removing it. You also have the option to download a CSV file for future reference. Next, I will delete this access key. Navigate and click on Deactivate as I no longer wish to use it. This will deactivate the access key. After refreshing the page, you will notice the key has been deactivated and removed. If I attempt to access the S3 bucket again, it will result in an error due to the invalid access key ID. Thank you for joining me at Elite Cloud for this tutorial.